reason why we're here is because West Hollywood has over one-third of their population that identify as gay, lesbian, transgender, or bisexual. And this is the reason why it's so important to be here. Because the person you're about to meet, you know, she is a staunch advocate for the LGBT community. And what's so interesting about Geena Rocero is that when she decided that she was going to come out, it made waves. Geena Rocero is elegant and poised, strong and confident, a model and an activist, and was born with the gender assignment of male. In 2014, on her 30th birthday, while giving a TED Talk in honor of International Transgender Day of Visibility, Geena came out.
I was assigned boy at birth based on the appearance of my genitalia.
Since her TED Talk, Geena has several projects surrounding her activism. She launched Gender Proud, an advocacy group that aims to uplift and advance the rights of transgender communities around the globe. Geena also feels that as a transgender person, that now it's important to produce content about the trans community.
Recently, we did a web series with Logo Channel called Beautiful As I Want to Be. What it means is, like, we specifically work with trans youth and ask them that question. How do you define beauty for your own identity?
Geena's hat as producer, bringing a sense of empowerment.
Having them tell their own story, you would see the complicated and rich and very nuanced, layered, you know, sort of storytelling. And I think when we have that, you know, we see, you know, the full humanity of trans people and LGBT people.
Geena's life, born in Manila and raised early on as a boy. By the age of 15, she was joining transgender beauty contests in the Philippines. Her family, supportive.
We've traveled around the Philippines and did that. It was almost like it's my first job because I was making money. So in a way, it's something that, you know, I would use to buy my hormones. So it was almost an economic, you know, empowerment for me.
At 17, Geena moved to the States. She was then discovered in New York by a photographer at a restaurant, eventually signing with Next Management, one of the largest modeling agencies in New York. Geena had undergone full sex reassignment surgery here in the U.S. and is identified as female on all legal U.S. documents. For over a decade, Geena was successfully modeling in print and on the runway and living as her true self, a woman.
It was expressed really early, but then when I moved to New York, I had to come back to the closet. It was a completely different time, so I made a conscious decision that, you know, I wasn't ready to talk about it. I wasn't, so my model agent did not know, you know, about my that I'm trans. And I just also didn't want to be, you know, pigeonholed for that specific because it's trans. And also, I wasn't ready. I wasn't, you know, I was scared. I was really scared.
But coming out a year and a half ago didn't kill her career. In fact, last year, Geena joined the CoverGirl campaign, Girls Can Change the World.
This is the photograph that led me to my journey as a model in New York.
The commercial giving her not only more visibility, but even more purpose in the transgender fight for understanding and equality.
Tell us what you would say to those that don't have a voice, that are afraid and that are watching. What do you have to say to them?
I think keep expressing your truth to the people that feel that they don't have a voice. I want them to know they have a voice.
Coming up next week, Geena has some words for Manny Pacquiao after his disparaging opinions about the LGBT community. Also, what Caitlyn Jenner said about Geena Rocero when they first met, and also what Geena is doing to try and change the law in the Philippines for transgender recognition. I'm Cher Calvin. Back to you.